What's going on, guys? It's Slider Havoc here, and we are back on Sky Factory, and we are going to start this episode off by doing something really, really stupid, but I think it's stupid with a very intelligent reason in the end. So, here's what we're going to go do. First, I'm going to get a chest, because, well, actually, you know, I don't even need a chest. Technically, I just need my golden bag of holding, because this is the upgraded one. But I'm going to get a chest anyways. I don't want to take any chances. So, we're going to be leaving a whole bunch of stuff behind here. Everything that I even remotely care about is getting... Oh, no. I need you. I don't need you. You're staying, definitely. And I won't... Don't think I'll need to fly... No, I won't, and I don't, well, I can make those pretty quick, easily, can't I? Gold, some unstable, some leather. Yeah, we'll take them just in case. I can make those. That's not a problem. Okay, and then I'm going to take you, and you, and you. You three are coming with me. Everything else is staying behind. This is what I'm taking with me. Because here's the deal, okay? I finally got a Rarity 6. I finally got a Rarity 6 Dimlet, and, well, I don't think I've got any more. I haven't checked since I got the one. No. What I had done was, I had finally, okay, well, let's get caught up before we go, because this is going to be fun and stupid and whatever. I have started what I call my Sky Mall. If you've ever flown on a plane in the seat back pocket in front of you, there's a little magazine there called Sky Mall. And since we're a floating void in the sky, I thought making a little mall would be very fitting. And here's our last Millennium Villager, or our last Villager. I thought it'd be great to pull him out for this because, well, I needed him to see all those crazy guys over there. I needed Dimensional Shards. So I went through all these guys, through all their trades, and, ooh, this guy's not exhausted. Cool. I need to get some more shards from him. I needed those shards so I could create a couple things. First thing is this phase field generator, which is going to protect me because I'm going to be going in. I'm intentionally going into a collapsed dimension, right? As you can see, my power just keeps going back to zero. I am not generating enough power. Yeah. But if I can get this guy set down, Activity Probe, if I can get in and get out real quickly, then the power can save up because it doesn't burn power if no one's in there. So that's what I'm going with there. Ooh, let me go ahead and take my armor off too. I just don't want to have to remake it. Pretty much. Don't want to have to remake my armor. Oh my god, I'm so slow. Oh my god, this is normal speed. It's like it's slow motion. Wow. Okay. But I can show you this over here. This might be the most corrupt and warped automated machine I have ever done. It's kind of twisted. I needed a lot of emeralds to deal with these guys. And actually, there was a couple of these guys I was actually making money off of because one guy was selling something for like one, and then one guy was buying it back for three. It was awesome. This is the most corrupt machine I have ever made. Let me... Oh, I got to take my baubles off too. Oh, bink, bink, bink. That was weird. Okay. I have to take the magnet off because it starts sucking up all that XP right there. So I needed emeralds. So check this out. This is kind of my fancy dancy machine here, right? What it basically does is all these guys get pumped in, and when they die in there, they make emerald. And then what's really cool is this starts to fill with emerald, and as you can see, I got a little tank back here that every so often it basically pulls see, you have to have a liquid in there if you don't know anything about this. You have to have a liquid in there for them to die. Right, and so what I've done is they constantly die and make emerald, and then this gold, and it happens so fast you don't even get to see it, the gold comes through here and then shoots back into the system, but it pulls the entire amount of gold out, so the emerald will switch back to the bottom, and then the emerald is filling this little doohickey right here, whatever it's called, the casting basin, and it's making emerald blocks. And then yeah, I've been getting quite a bit of emerald. Before we go, I want to see. Oh yeah, I gotta show you this. I totally forgot. I just finished that. But as you can see, I got 39 blocks of emerald and 132 extra emeralds. Because one of those guys just drops emeralds. I don't know which one, but This thing, and then I'll now explain this here. I don't know too much about the turbines yet. And to be honest with you, I think I could probably make this a slightly better build, but I want to keep those cores as cool as possible. So, there is the concept of active cooling and passive cooling. I was looking into the active cooling. This is passive cooling. Dump some freaking, you know, liquid in there, keep it cool, right? And I'm currently yielding 52,000 RF per tick. That's freaking pretty good, I think. You can actually see the number right there. And as you can see, I also increased my vibrant capacitor bank here. It now holds up to 250 million and it puts out 250,000 RF per tick, which is enough to cover this world. This world uses 144.62 RF per tick, right? But obviously I'm not generating that much. So this is going to kill me when I go in. But the reason I'm so excited is I finally got my rarity 6, which means I have my draconic world. This is my draconic world. Let me do a real quickie click because you know what? It's... Oh, you know what? That's a good way to save up energy. That could be a much safer way to do this. I didn't even think about that. Hey, why don't I pump a whole bunch of energy into this? Duh. Pull the thing out. So, here is the specs on this world. It is terrain void, right? The base block is stone, which is fine, but huge ore blocks of draconium ore. Base loads water, whatever, I don't care. Controller magical, I don't even know what that means, but feature huge orbs. It's going to be daytime. It's going to be bright. It's going to be noon, period. There's going to be no rain ever. It's going to be awesome. So what I need to do, see, like, I'm not even outputting that much. This thing, I'm not going to get very long in there, and I guess this will be a little safer now, but I'm still leaving stuff behind. I ain't even messing around with that. I've got this guy right here, the phase field generator. Basically, it temporarily protects me from dying, basically. And, okay, so we're up to 63 million. I was doing some calculations, and this thing right here says 144,000 RF per tick, right? So times 20, that's about, what was I thinking? It was about two and a half million RF a second, right? And so approximately, my numbers are kind of off, but I'm just doing this quick math in my head. But this is a 250 million bank, right? So it gives me 10 seconds to get in, place this block, get out. Then I can get this thing fully charged up to whatever they fully charge to, 40 million. I don't know, whatever it is. But it's going to give me about 10 seconds. And actually, to be honest with you, I probably have enough in there right now. So we're going to do this. I'm going to put this guy in here. I'm so scared right now. So scared. Okay. You're getting energy. Let's go. I've already got the dialer on. I'm so scared. This probably is like one of the stupidest things I've ever done. But I'm going to be so happy to see all the draconic. I'm like probably already dead. Okay, so I'm I don't know how long I can stay without taking damage. I want to get a monitor is actually what I should probably do. I know there's a monitor you can keep in your inventory, but look at that, it's all draconic ore right there. It's such a beautiful thing. Let's get a monitor, then I can check the health. So now, this is the cool part. This is the whole reason I'm putting that block down. As you can see, it's got its 40 million RF. It's already filled up, okay? So it's good, right? It's about, I don't know, half a second or so. well, 1 second is, what, added times two, so it's 28. So it's 280. And then times 10 is 2,800,000. Okay, so 2,800,000 RF per second. So basically 40 million. And keep it open for a little while. And then I'll have another 250 in here when this thing gets fully charged up. So let's go make the monitor. It's this little red guy. This guy? Dimensional monitor. Yes. Okay, cool. I don't have any blank. Let me... Let's go turn this guy off real quick so it'll catch any blink dimlets that are coming in. Ahaha! Perfect. I don't even know why. How did you get in there? Oh, man. I keep doing this. I just want energy going to that thing. It keeps sticking junk in there from... Oh, you're going to be doing it too, aren't you? Yeah, you are. Because it's connected to my deep dark. Put the dimlets in now. I just needed to. There we go. Putting dimlets in. There we go. Cool. Well, fortunately, it was a backlog. Made it a lot easier. What I was trying to say was... There... Okay, cool. Dimensional. Not an RF tool dimension. I don't get that at all. Does this have to be charged? No. This just tells me the power of the dimension I'm in, I believe. So it kind of tells me how safe it is. So I am going to do this real quick. I've got this silk touchy pick. And I'm going to go in and get as much ore as possible, basically. That's what we're going to do. I'm going to leave what I don't need. So I don't need this junk here. And, oh, I'm definitely going to want you on. I'm going to go ahead and put my armor and stuff back on because I now see that I've got a decent amount of safe time. And I don't need you. My sword I don't need. My crossbow I don't need. I wouldn't mind getting this set up too just to see how much power I can generate. Because my goal is to make a self-sustaining dimension. And if I can make this dimension self-sustaining... by powering it from the inside, where basically I just make another one of these dimensional builders and place it in that with this identical card, that would be awesome. That would be totally awesome. And so let's get set up here. You all back on, and then armor back on just in case. And then this guy here, I don't think I necessarily need him, but I'm taking him anyways. And I got my wings so I can fly. So we're good. We're good. Okay. I'm not leaving much behind. Okay. We're good. So. This guy's all charged up. Where are you at? You're maxed. You are full. You have 250 million RF. Okay, cool. This dimension should be safe for a wee bit. So we can go in and get a whole bunch of Draconic Ore real quick. And we should be good. Hopefully that dimensional monitor works. And yes, okay, so it's bright green, which is good. So I just got to keep an eye on that. But look at all this Draconic Ore. Oh my gosh, I never thought I would be able to get this much. This is freaking amazing. Like, the concept was, I think valid. But, oh, I forgot my cookies. Yeah, now I'm going to take damage just because I forgot my cookies. All right, well, we can get out of here real quick. And I can bring cookies back with me. So I can warm up. I think it'll stay stable for a little while. Let's see how much energy that really drained, though. That's a good check on the system. A little chunk. So we can stay in there for a bit. A bit. Not really long, but a bit. We're going to go fill up our inventory. You know what? I'm taking a golden bag of holding. I am taking a golden bag of holding. We are going to get as much Draconic Ore as possible. Which is really funny. Here we go. Yeah, this is the special one. That wasn't the special one. This is the special one. Okay, let's go do this. Let's go do this. Oh my gosh. And I want to make a dimension with, what's it called? I didn't eat my cookies. Well, that's just silly of me. Oh, there we go. I'm still taking damage. But I need this guy in my hotbar because it keeps my pick, running smoothly. Okay, cool. So let's do this. Let us do this. Vein Miner, you are my friend. Okay, let's get all this stuff picked up. There we go. I need to leave you there. You're the one I don't have to have in my hotbar at the moment. Actually, I ain't messing around. Yeah, there we go. So we're gonna go and eat our cookie. There we go. And we're going to go ahead and get all this. Can I? Yes, I can. Cool. Let's do this. Oh my gosh. Look at how much beautiful Draconic Ore I'm going to have. Oh my gosh. 4 days. This was like the best Christmas present ever. Look at all of this stuff. We are so resurrecting the Ender Dragon today. And we're going to get our Wavern stuff. That's what we're doing. We are getting our Wavern armor today. Or Draconic armor, sorry. We are getting all that cool stuff today. Okay. How's the monitor doing? Monitor's doing good. We're doing okay. I'm really scared to be in here because I'm so underpowered for this dimension. This dimension is, I mean, it's just requesting way more than I even have. Oh, look at all this beautiful stuff. Look at all this beautiful stuff. Hey, get up here. Get up! There we go. Get back up! There we go. Oh my gosh, you guys. I've never, ever farmed like this before. This is just amazing. Oh my gosh. I filled my golden bag of holding. Okay. That was an effective trip. The monitor says we're still good. So let's go ahead and just fill my inventory. And we're going to get back and smelt all this up. And oh my gosh. I'm really surprised, actually, because it's this normal ore, and I don't know if that's just an ore dictionary issue. I got all the ores in the ender, in the end. That's where I did all the absorption. But I guess it's just draconic ore, so it just kind of has its own name. Oh, the monitor's going down. The monitor's going down. Let's get out of here. Monitor said, we're dying. Get out. Oh my god, that is so awesome, though. That is so awesome. So, we made it out. Whoa, stop clicking on stuff. And you should be gaining power back now. Oh no, you're put a little charge back onto this guy because I just drained it. So get you back up to 40 million, right? And then hopefully it stops and I just want to make sure it's not flexing and stuff like that. Yes, it does. No flexing, good. And then you're going to start building back up, right? You're not building back up. There it goes. Yep. At 53,000 RF per tick. Oh my goodness. So the other thing I was thinking is doing Yalorium. Oh, that's right. I was in the process of doing that before I started recording. yeah. We're going to go ahead and just start smelting you up. Or is it pulverize? Pulverize? Yeah, we're going to start pulverizing you up. And I need to grab you. Well, I didn't need to grab you, but grab some cables because I was in the... This is what I was in the process of doing, actually. Can I put you in there? Yeah, I got room. Okay, cool. I was going to start auto-connecting Yellowrite because that was another thing is I'm probably going to remodify this dimension in between now and then, pull this out, and I want to add some Yellowrite huge orbs as well so I can farm the heck out of those because what I'm doing right now... is basically I've got an export bus right here with Yellowrite, so it just pumps right into my reactor, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put an import bus right here like a soul. Yep, go ahead and let's go ahead and put you guys in here for right now, right? Oh, I'm so excited. I have a freaking awesome dimension to go to with all the draconic ore I could ever possibly use. What is taking you so long? What is taking you so long? Supposedly you're crafting some Certus Quartz dust in the pulverizer, which I'm currently using. Duh. But you should have, like, you should have... Did I add an extra channel that makes you... No, you guys only have 3 channels. Why are you not... Do I do that weird clicky-click thing? Nope. No, you went. Okay. Okay, I didn't yield any extra. Or maybe it was just going... It was really empty and slowly. That could have been it. Might need to put some speed filters on there. But whatever. Dude, I am so excited right now. Like, there are no words for my excitement. Yeah, there we go. I'm going to keep dumping some of you in there. You know. And finish doing you over here. I need my wrench or my hammer or whatever it's called. Oh my gosh. so much draconic ore. It's just so awesome. Okay, there we go. So I can get you out real quick. And you're going to go bingo bango right there. Right? And where... Oh, yeah. I'm still waiting on that import bus. There it is. Oh, my gosh. I'm like... My heart is racing a little bit because I was literally so excited that I finally got that done. Let's see. So I'm only using two channels. So this should be just automatically taking the blue-rite, whatever that stuff, the plutonium out. And yellow-rite's going in. And I just want to make sure the fuel is full. It is. And the blue-rite just comes out when it's done. Oh, freaking awesome. And are you back up to, you're almost back up to 250 million. I could go in for another run, but I don't need to. I don't need to. Because I can actually use like the second pulverizer as my personal. No, guess not. But I can do this. I'm going to dump like this. I'm just going to go ahead and leave. Oh, just do this. There we go. I know I'm not talking at this moment, but it's because I'm trying to process. I'm going to create a recipe, a pattern. Come on. There we go. From the ore itself. So it'll send it to the pulverizer, then it'll send it to the what's it called? The redstone furnace. Like a soul. Okay. So, let's make a pattern here. Oh. God, I'm so excited. This is freaking amazing. Draconic. I got 4,992 of those. And these all yield like four each. Oh my gosh. Okay. So one of you gives me one of those. That's right. Pattern. Thank you. And one of you gives me one of those. Like so. And you're going to go in the redstone furnace. So... where are you guys at? You're down here? Yeah, redstone and pulverizer. Okay, cool. So, draconic dust from draconic ore goes in the pulverizer. And draconic ingot from dust goes there. And let us make ourselves, let's say, 100 draconic ingots. I think that sounds like a good recipe. 100 of them. Because I can. That's why. Because I can. Oh, look at that. I already had 100 dust, so it didn't really matter. So let's get that dust and stuff back in there. Oh my god, that's so amazing. Oh, I will never need it again. Okay, so we are going to get ready. I can do 250 in here. So we're going to get ready to res the dragon. Okay, so the first thing I need is... I need to bring that back up. I need to see that again real quick. Oh, over here. Okay, so we're going to need 4 diamond blocks. We're going to need 4 in... What is it called? Energized draconic blocks. We're going to need the resurrection stone, 4 obsidian, 4 glowstone, and 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 quartz pillars. We can do this. We can do this. Okay. So, first of all, quartz. How do I make a quartz pillar? I forget. Is it just 4 of these like this? Nope. It's just 2. Yep. So, I need 12 of these, right? So, I need 6. There we go. Bingo, bingo. I got 14 out of it. That's okay. 2 for extra. Bing, bing. All right. And then a diamond block. We need... 4 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then draconic. I have 117 ingots. Oh my gosh. This is so awesome. I need 4 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now this, I don't know how long it's going to take. It shouldn't take too long. There we go. Are you doing one at a time? Oh yeah. See, the first one's going to fill up really fast. The second one will fill up really fast. The third one is going to take some time because it's, you know, well, it's I'm draining 200,000 RF per tick into that block. I wonder if that's just as fast as it goes, because my max is 250 out and it's only taking 198, so that might be as fast as you can do a draconic block. That might be it. So that might be as fast as I can possibly do it. And eventually I will have an entire bank of these. I want to make this thing massive. Just storage for days, energy storage for days, until I get to the draconic evolution one, that is. But yeah, so I'll explain this guy real quick while we're sitting here. I needed more power, and I was looking at the dimensions on these things, and I'm not even close to the max dimensions right now. Let's see, I'm standing at 65, and I can go up 48 blocks. So 48 blocks would actually be 48 blocks from 65. 40 would be 105, and then 8 more would be 113. So I could technically go higher by 17 more blocks, and then I can go 32 by 32. Okay, that I think that'd be a monstrous machine, and I think I don't know, I'm debating between that and doing a couple turbines. Now the turbines, they're pretty efficient in smaller, you know, packages or whatever, and I can get like 20,000 ticks per turbine. So if I did a couple turbines, you know, I think I'd be able to get a lot. But I kind of like working with just the reactor. So maybe what I'll end up doing is like probably off on this end over here, I'm gonna try to do a 32 by 32 by 48, one of these, and then do my same pattern of alternating the coils, or not the coils, but the rods, and kind of see how that looks and works. I don't know if doing the spacing in between them is a good idea for cooling purposes or not, because look how hot this thing runs. This thing runs insanely hot now. It's all the way up at 16,000 Celsius, so it runs pretty hot, which basically means I'm burning more fuel. I'm almost at a full millibucket per tick. So basically every 1,000 ticks, I'm burning an ingot. That's a lot of yellowrite I need, which is why I'd like to be able to make a yellowrite world. But I've got like 500, so we're gonna be good for a while. And I still have yellowrite coming in from this place, and I didn't even look to see if I had any ore. Yeah, see, I got 102 ore. Let's go ahead and smelt those up while we're talking about this stuff here. Okay, so those are already charged. Wow, that is really fast, actually. Okay, now, actually, I'm going to need 4 more of these, because I want to... Well, no, we're not going to do that right now. We're just going to go awaken the dragon and reawaken the dragon, I should say, and get that done. So let us crossbow and bolts. And whatever I don't need right now, I'm going to go ahead and put in the golden bag of holding. So I don't need, well, the portal I'm going to take with me. I don't need you. I will have you on me. I don't need the phase shield generator. This is actually going to go back in the inventory. Hammer. Okay. And other golden bag of holding, and you, and you, and you. Okay. So you're going to stay here because that is dimensional shards, which I'm going to want more of. And my cookie. And the hammer I don't need. Yeah, I think that's good. Okay. So now over here, you're going to go in the system. I don't need the hammer. I don't need this or this. And hardened strongbox I don't need. Golden bag of holding can go in the golden bag of holding, because there's another golden bag of holding inside that one. And I do need to charge up my porter real quick. You know, and I might start charging up the next 4 blocks. Yeah, I might do that. 1, 2, 3, 4. While I'm gone, I was thinking there was a reason I wanted to go back over there, but I don't think there is. Okay. So we're going to start charging you up, because I don't have any need for extra power right now. Oh, not you guys. You guys, I'm gonna start charging you up, because that's gonna be for the next output is 251. Okay, so it is outputting full on. I mean, it did say like 189 earlier, didn't it? I don't know. But that is definitely outputting. It's inputting at 50. Oh, it was a net. Okay, that makes more sense. So it's maxing out. So I can, the more I have these, the more I could, you know, output. Cool. We are, did I charge that guy up? I did charge the porter up. We're going to go ahead and head to the, oh, wow, totally forgot about this stuff on me when I went over there. We're going to head to the end. And we're going to hope for the best. This is power. We're going to give you a name. Not that it matters because I just used the porter to get home. So we're going to head to the end. Oh, no, hold on. Before I do that, obsidian. Whoa, why don't I have power? Am I draining all my power here? Yeah, I am. Hold on. Let's stop that so I can get some power over here, please. Thank you. I need some obsidian. I need 4 obsidian. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I need some glowstone. Oh, there we go. Craft. 4 of those, please. Thank you. And then, oh, yes, we have to make the resurrection. That's not it. Oh, there's so many of these things. Unstable reservoir. So many things I want to make and play with. At Draconic, I'm going to see it. There it is. Resurrection stone, yeah. I just don't know how to spell. Okay, so I need 4 wavering cores and 4 mob souls. These were the mob soul. Every time I talk about mob souls, this is what I needed them for. And that's just a regular draconian block. Cool. Wavering core. Okay, cool. So I've got plenty of the ingots. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many did I need? 1, 2, 3, 4. You know what? I already got a couple made. I already have a couple made. Yeah, because I have 21 of them. Let's see. Like so. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, perfect. How often does that happen? And we got the resurrection stone. All right, cool. Look at all the mobbies. Look at all the mobbies. I got 51 Enderman mobby souls. Okay, so we'll be able to run this thing a couple times if need be. And let me go ahead and put you away. So we've got this thing to set up. And I'm going to take an angel block. Because that way I can just set it up as soon as we get there. This flight might take a while because we have to go back to where the Enderman spawns. Or not the Enderman, the Ender Dragon spawns. And so I might take a little pause, depending on, I think I'm almost 10,000 blocks away. So it's going to take a second to fly over there. Fortunately, I got my trusty little porter here. Oh, I forgot the glowstone. I don't think my wireless has range this far. I don't think it's going to happen. All right, let's get that glowstone. Okay, glowstone. You're in here. Glowstone. Like so. And gotta charge you back up. Oh, come on. Do your thing. Do your thing. Oh, I want to get those other 2 draconic blocks done too. Draconic blocks. Craft 100 of them because I can. I've got 2. I need 4 for this, so 2 go in there. And there you go. And there's 2 more, right? Oh, that one already has some of a charge. Okay, cool. There we go. You guys go back in there. Do your thing. I'm heading to the... I grabbed that, right? Yeah, okay. Let's head to the end. Let's go resurrect the dragon. I hear he looks different. I hear that he's not technically the vanilla dragon. But if I get another egg, that would be cool. Because then I would actually think about hatching that other egg. So that could be cool. Alright, so we're heading this way. I fly pretty quickly. So we may not need to break. Too close to the Chaos Dragon. Way too close to the Chaos Dragon. Oh, wasn't thinking about where I was going when I did that. Let's get by that bad boy. Okay, I'm going to pause, and then we're going to come back when we're back towards where the Ender Dragon originally spawned. So we'll be right back. I literally almost flew right by. I didn't remember exactly where it was at. I just knew the general area. But I'm so ready to do this right now. I am so, so ready. Wow, I fly so fast. Okay. So Angel, block us up. Okay. So I know it's got to be within range, but I know it's going to be because it's got to be in range of the pillars. And I know that. There we go. So the resurrection goes right here. Okay. And then the obsidian go in a T pattern, like so. I have a feeling I'm going to need like a wavering core, and this is really going to upset me that I didn't bring one with me. Like, there's obviously going to be... Oh, no! Silk touch. Okay. Hey, come on. There we go. And you, and you. And then this, okay, this, based upon what the book says, it doesn't have to be, like, perfectly, like, in the shape. These items just have to be in the area. So, I mean, I'm going to do it exactly as the thing I'm looking at shows to do it, but it says that they don't have to be, like, you know, exactly set up this way. They just have to be close. So, we're going to go there and there. There and there. There and there. There and there. Oh, no, you know what? These are all supposed to be just one, not two. Man, that pick picks so fast. These ones are all just one. Okay. There we go. There we are. And then off to the side a little bit. One, two, three. I'm gonna go ahead and just make it pretty. One, two, three. I mean, as pretty as it can be with dirt, right? Okay, and then these are supposed to be too high. Oh, yeah, I gotta do this one too. One, two. One, two. And then, what am I... Oh, I didn't put these over here. Okay. Don't need that anymore. All right. So, one, two. Now, the corners get the charged draconic blocks. And I'm going to be very upset with myself because I know I'm going to need, like, a core to start this thing. And I didn't read it all the way through. And I'm going to be very upset. Hopefully, it's just, like, a right click with your hand. That would be awesome, right? Okay, so resurrection stone, place it in the pillars in symmetrical pattern. Okay, the ritual is activated by right clicking the resurrection stone once. Oh, okay, cool. It is just a right click. Oh, it worked. Nothing ever works the first time for me, ever. All right, so we are resing the ender dragon, and look at all the endermen just getting zapped. All right, let's see how well my crossbow works. There's a crystal there. Got you, and the crystal there. Nope, Enderman. Enderman took one for the team there. This crossbow's got, like, pretty decent range and, like, speed. Like, straightness and stuff like that, so I can get most of these pretty quickly. It's not going to be, like, my last trip here. That's for sure. It's kind of unfair that I don't even give the Enderman, like, the Ender Dragon a chance to, like, recharge with these crystals. Like, you don't even get it to start. Wow, I think I got him all. Oh, he's coming along. He's coming along, all right. Did I get them all? Did I get all the crystals? I can't tell. Oh, here he goes. There he is. He's still in the process of regenerating. I should probably stop trying to shoot him until he's done getting... There we go. I mean, they seem to do pretty good damage. But he regens so fast. Why is he regening so fast? I should just hit him with my sword. My sword does like 70 damage. Okay, screw this. We're hitting him with the sword. Should only take... Oh, wow, never mind. There he goes. Did I get the heart? I got the heart. Okay, that's pretty sick. That is pretty sick. All that XP is just wasted, but I got the heart, which is all I really cared about, because now I can do some awakened stuff. And is that entire thing, like, gone? The obsidian's still there, but everything else is gone. Okay. Not a problem. We got the heart. That was pretty quick and easy. We can do that whenever we want. I just need to put a portal somewhere over here so I don't have to keep flying. But so it goes for the time being. All right. So now all we got to do is just awaken the heart with the explosion. And, well, how are you doing? Oh, you're both done. Oh, we've got this. We've got this. Herobrine was here. This bothers me when this stuff does that. That is just so freaky. Herobrine was here. Take off, Herobrine. I don't want your type here. Okay, so I know I got to blow the heart up, and then I got to throw in the right amount of cores. It's the Wavering cores. Let me get the book real quick. This is something that I've already done once before, but I wanted to definitely do with you guys on camera. And, oh, you know what? I know where you're at. You're in here. And so might as well just do it right now because I want to get some of these blocks made. Where are you at? The dragon heart is used for awakened draconian block. There we go. That's not really helping me. There's the ritual. Okay. So you have been studying, yeah, blah, blah, blah. You have been bringing out the truth, power, dragon heart. See, dragon heart page for details. That, okay, that makes more sense. Okay, cool. Drop a dragon heart on the ground and activate it with explosion. Done, okay. 4 to 16, draconic cores. Okay, not a problem. We can make those. Draconic cores. I can make some more of those. I've got 4. I want 16 of them. I want 16 of them. Draconic core. I'm low on gold, actually. That kind of sucks. Not for long, I'm not. Okay, we will have plenty of gold in moments. Go, gold, go! Alright. So, how many did I already have? I have 5. I want 16, so I need, well, obviously, 11 more. Gold. Wow, that was really fast. Bink, bink. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Perfect. Okay, cool. Got the heart. I'm going to need a TNT. Of course, I can't. Oh. Let me just make it. I. This T thing is killing me. Absolutely killing me. Okay, TNT and a lever. Like a soul. And we'll go ahead and make this thing out of obsidian because I can mine up obsidian pretty quickly now. Obsidian. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Just a stack, whatever. I got my TNT. Okay, cool. And we're going to do this over... We're going to do this right over here. I think like the witherproof blocks is like a safe place to do it. I'm not going to do any type of extra like external damage, and all these blocks are designed to take an explosion in the area. So actually I might just do it like this. If it's witherproof, I'm assuming that block won't blow out, but to be safe, I don't want to lose like my heart and stuff like that, although it shouldn't. We're going to go ahead and place the TNT, right? And we're going to put a lever right here. Okay, and I got my heart in my inventory. So we flip it a switch. Throw the heart out there. And did it work? No, because my stupid magnet pulled it away. Ah! All these things with throwing stuff on the ground. Ah, constantly messing with me on that. Fortunately, I left the recipe in here, so TNT and a lever. Every freaking time I have to throw something on the ground. I forget that magnet's on me, and bad things happen. I like how, okay, so this is funny, and occasionally see one over here. There are two spots on this platform that mobs can spawn. They're in both of these chambers. The poor mobs just die in there, and then their stuff gets sent in. It's funny. It entertains me. Okay, so there's you. So we're going to throw you like that and flip other switch. There we go. Now I fell in the hole. All right. So you're going to start spinning, and you're going to start sucking stuff up, and I'm going to donate to the cause. There it goes. There's the cause. There we are. All right. And then we're going to take, I can do four. So we're going to place you guys right around here. And you're already donating out, but oh yeah, okay, it's going to the blocks. That was really fast this time. Last time I did this, it was really slow. Maybe it was just waiting for more, I don't know. But it was like really slow. So let's see, that's gonna give me quite a few ingots actually. Let's see if I can get like one piece of armor done, just to finish this up. Let's see. Draconic. We've got, like, I don't know what the expense of these are. The pick would be pretty cool too, but okay, so like the sword here. Two of the ingots, my sword, a draconic energy core, and an awakened core. Okay. And that is for wavering cores, which is for draconic. Wow. Okay. I mean, I've got everything we need. Absolutely everything we need. So we're good. I'm just going to go ahead and request 1,000 ingots. Seems like a reasonable number to me. And in the time being, I'm going to pause here. I'm going to make all the patterns for all these things, so it should be pretty quick and easy. And then, I think that'd be the best. Because I've got a pattern for draconic cores, and then draconic cores will make the wyvern core. So then, yeah. I think that's what I'll end up doing. So let's go ahead and, yep, okay, we'll be back in just a moment. All right, guys, so I've got a lot of the, I requested 1,000, but I don't need 1,000 right now, so I'm going to stop that real quick. I've got all the recipes done, and so now I just have to, I'm going to do one at a time, but I think I might actually be able to do all four pieces of my armor, which would actually be pretty freaking sweet. Because I want to take on that Chaos Dragon. He's killed me a couple times and makes me not such a happy camper. Alright, so we're going to need one Draconic Energy and one Draconic, or Awakened. So let me get one of these. And Awakened. One of these. And they craft up pretty quick because I got all the materials. Nothing's really like Draconic. So I just need to go like that. All right. And then let me take my armor off real quick. I don't know if I can do it with charged, or when it's already charged or not. It should. We have our first piece of draconic armor. Oh, that's so epic. I think one of these actually gives me the ability to fly, doesn't it? Or maybe it's a complete set gives me the ability to fly. I'm not 100% sure. Let's put my angel wings in there. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is outstanding. Okay, let's see if we can make another one. Awakened. Let's try making like three of these. And draconic. Let's try making three of these. Nope. I'm going to need to do that. Okay. Well, until next time, guys, we have stepped into the world of draconic. I'm going to be fully draconic'd out when we come back next time. Wow, this was a really long episode. I really did not plan for it to be this long. But we're getting really close to taking on the Chaos Dragon. And I don't even know what's so good about it other than he's just a really hard boss. So we'll find out. That is probably what's going to lead to some of the... Ooh, Trauma Dislocation. Ooh. I think I can make the advanced one. Yeah, I've been wanting this thing. Let's do this real quick. I know I can make that. That I can make because I don't need any draconium or the awakened draconium. Charm. This I could really, really use. Like a soul. Let me get the Eye of Ender. Thank you. Oh, I'm excited. I've been wanting this thing for quite a while now. There we go. And then I just gotta make that guy. Jeez. What's this one called? It's just so much easier to look at the name. Wyvern Core. Wyvern Core. There you go. Let's make one of those. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, I'm not 100% sure how it works, but I know it uses RF or something like that. Okay, so this is how we're gonna get around now. Looking right at my power station. Set here. This is gonna be power station. add new. Power station. Commute. Last millennium cords. What's add fuel? Out of ender pearls. Okay. Let me show you this. 175,000 ender pearls. Add fuel. I don't know if I. Oh, I wish there was a faster way to do this. Because I've got a whole lot of them in my inventory right now. Okay. So I'm gonna go around now that I have this guy, and I believe, I mean, it just, I don't know, there's gotta be a faster way. There's got to be a faster way. Let's try it out though. So do. And it just brings me here. I didn't look at how much it is. Okay, I have 186. Let's go way out here. And that's pretty far. Okay. How much did that actually use? Just one. Just one. Okay. So now I can set the respawn location for the dragon and the chaos dragon, and I don't have to worry about any other portals. I've got this bad boy now. That is freaking amazing. We're gonna go to 300 for the moment. There we go. That is so sick. So another useful thing that we've done today. And yeah, fuel will never be an issue. Oh, this is so sick. I'm gonna run around and set so many points. Oh, this is so cool. Oh, I'm so excited. I should have made this thing a long time ago. That really wasn't that expensive. Other than I didn't have the draconic iron, but ingots, but whatever. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys had a good one. I hope you enjoyed resing the dragon and knocking him out. We made our first piece of draconic armor. And when we come back next time, I will be fully draconic'd up because we're going to go take on that dragon a couple more times. So until next time, guys, I'm Slaughter Havoc, and I'm out of here. Peace.